Good morning, Mahendra. My name is P. Krishna. I am from ECE department. And today I am going to explain the concept called controllability and observability. Right? So what is controllability and what is observability? Right. So coming to the controllability, so the definition states that a system is said to be controllable if and only if it is possible to transfer a given system to a desired output with the help of the initial state, and within a specified time, if you get the desired output, then the system is said to be controllable. In a single word, I can say, so like getting the desired output by applying the control input value, it's nothing but a controllability. Coming to the observability, like with the help of the measured output value, if it is possible to determine the initial state of a system, then the system is said to be observable, right? So these are the two important topics in control system, and there is a test called Kalman test, and with the help of that Kalman test, we will be able to verify whether the system is controllable or observable, right? So we'll start with the controllability. So the controllability, the Kalman test for the Kalman is the name of a scientist who actually proposed these two concepts, and he has given the test also, and that's why this test is known as a Kalman test, right? So according to this Kalman test, so any given system is said to be controllable if and only if the rank of a composite matrix is equal to n. So what does it say? So the rank must be equal to rank of composite matrix QC is equals to n, right? So what is n here? So where n is number of states, number of initial states, I can say, or state variables, you can say number of state variables. And coming to the structure of the composite matrix, QC for the controllability, it starts with B. So that's the first column of the composite matrix, B, followed by matrix A, matrix B, so multiplication, followed by A square B, so on. So the last column is A to the power of n minus 1 into B. So the first column is B, next column is AB, next column is A square B, so on. The final column of this composite matrix is A to the power of n minus 1 into B, right? So what is A and B, right? So we already know the state equations of a given system. So the state equation x dot t is equals to A x of t plus B u of t, and followed by the output equation y of t is equals to C x of t plus D u of t. So A and B, C and D are arbitrary matrices, and the order of A is n by n, right? And coming to the x of t, the capital X of t is a state vector which consisting of state variables, and coming to the u of t is your input vector, so where it contains the input values, right? Okay, so now, so we need to find the controllability of a given system. So let me take a simple example, and we are going to verify whether the system is controllable or not. So the example is, so let us say a system whose state equation is given by A x of t plus B u of t with matrix A is order of 2 by 2, whose values are 1, 1, 0, minus 1, and coming to the B matrix is equals to 1, 0. So these are the values of a typical system, and let us verify whether this typical system, given system, is controllable or not, right? So now we have to find the controllability. So what is the criteria? So the criteria says, so we need to find the rank of a given system, and if the rank of a given system is equals to n, which is nothing but the number of state variables, then the particular system is said to be controllable, right? So first we will derive the composite matrix, right? So as I said, the composite matrix structure is B followed by AB followed by A square B and followed by so on e to the power of n minus 1 B, right? Now, so what is the value of n here? As I said, this the order of the matrix A is n by n, but in this particular case it is 2 by 2. So I can say n equals to 2, so therefore the structure of the composite matrix will be B AB only, because so it will stop at n minus 1, so n minus 1 is 1 only, right? So we know already B, so we have to find the product of AB. So what is B here? So A is 1 1 0 minus 1, which is 2 by 2, and B is 1 0, which is 2 by 1. So the columns and rows are matching, so therefore it is possible to do the multiplication. Now let us do the multiplication. Row with column, so 1 into 1 it's 1 plus 1 into 0 is 0, right? Next row with number, 0 into 1 0 minus 1 into 0 0, so 0 plus 0. So I can say, so this one is 1 and 0, so the product of AB is 1 0. Now let us substitute these values here. So what is B? B is 1 0, and what is AB? AB is also 1 0. Now this is the values of the composite matrix 1 1 0 0. Now let us find the order of the matrix, composite matrix. So how to find the order of the matrix? So to find the order of the composite matrix, so we should start with the highest order, then try to determine the determinant, and if the determinant is not zero, then we can say that so the order of the matrix is that particular order, right? So let us go with this straight away, 2 by 2. So find the order of this one, so determinant. So let me find the determinant of QC, which is 2 by 2 matrix. So 1 into 0 0, again 0 into 1 is 0, so determinant is 0, and I can say, so since the determinant is 0, so the order of the composite matrix QC is not equals to n, which is equals to 2. So therefore the system is not controllable, because the order of the composite matrix, which is not equals to 2. So in this way, so we can determine the controllability. So similarly, if you want to find the observability, so as I said, the observability is, so by measuring the output, if it is possible to determine the initial state of a given system, then that particular system is said to be observable, right? So again, so as I said, these two topics are proposed by the Kalman. So again, we have a test, which is known as the Kalman test, to find the observability of a given system. So again, to find the observability of a given system, so the logic is same. So rank of the composite matrix should be equals to n, but here the structure of the composite matrix is different. So this is the structure of the composite matrix to find the controllability, but to find the observability of a system, the structure of the composite matrix is a little bit different. So let me write the structure here. The structure will start with C transpose, and here it is A transpose into C transpose, A transpose square into C transpose, so on. So the last column is A transpose power n minus 1 into C transpose. So this is the structure of a composite matrix, which we are going to use to find whether the system is an observable or not, right? So this is the structure that we will be using to find whether the system is observable or not. So as I said, the first column is C transpose, and the second column, so it is C transpose into A transpose, and the third column is C transpose into A transpose square, and so on. The final it's C transpose into A transpose power n minus 1. Right? So let us go with a simple example. So let me take A values. A values is 1, 1, minus 2, and minus 1. And the C matrix. So and the C matrix is 1, 0. And the C matrix is 1, 0. Since we need only these two matrices, so let me write the output matrix, the output equation, C x of t plus d u of t. As I said, A, B, C, D are the arbitrary matrices, and out of this A matrix size is always n by n. Right? So as I said, x of t is a state vector and u of t is an input vector, and y of t is the output vector or output equation, you can say, and x dot of t is your state equations. Right? Now the composite matrix is C transpose, and here it is C transpose into A transpose, and C transpose into A transpose square, and so on. Here it is C transpose A transpose power n minus 1. Right? So let us find the composite matrix first. Then once you have the composite matrix, so try to find the order of the composite matrix and compare the order of the composite matrix with the given n. If both are equal, then we can say it is an observable. Otherwise, it is not observable. Right? So let us find C transpose. So we know C is 1, 0. So I can say C transpose is 1 and 0. Right? Now what is A? Matrix A is 1, 1, minus 2 and minus 1. So let us find the transpose of matrix A. It's 1, 1, minus 2 and minus 1 is the transpose of the matrix A. Right? Okay. So find the product of this. Now, so since the order is 2 by 2, I can say n equals to 2, then in this particular case, the composite matrix will be comprises of only two columns. So one is C transpose, and the second column is C transpose into A transpose. Because so n value is 2, so we have to go with up to n minus 1. So n minus 1 is 1 only. So therefore, I am going to stop it A transpose power 1 only. So there are only two columns. So anyway, we have this C transpose which is 1, 0. So let us find the product of C transpose into A transpose. So A transpose is this and C transpose is this. So 1 minus 2, 1 minus 1. And this is A transpose, and coming to the C transpose, it is 1, 0. Right. So we need to find the product of this one, A transpose into C transpose. So this is A transpose, and coming to the C transpose, it is 1, 0. Right. So let us find the product here. The first row into first column. So 1 into 1, it's 1. Plus minus 2 into 0 is 0. Now coming to the second row, 1 into 1 is 1, minus 1 into 0 is 0. Right? So now the values of this product is 1 and 1. So let us substitute these two values. So the product of A transpose into C transpose 1, 1, and C transpose is 1, 0. So therefore, your composite matrix is, so the first row, first column is 1, 0, and the second column is 1, 1. Right? So now let us determine the order of this particular system, so the particular matrix. So let me go with the highest order 2 by 2. So I can say, so this 1 minus 0 divided by 1, which is not equals to 0. So therefore, I can say the order of or the rank of this QC is 2, which is equals to n. So therefore, I can say that. So the system which is governed by these two equations with matrix A and matrix C is said to be controllable. So it is observable, right? So this is regarding the controllability and observability, and thank you.